Hello and greetings from Iceland. I have big news today. Not just the Reykjanes Peninsula, we need to talk about the volcano Askja as well, where things are literally heating up. But I'm starting with the good old Reykjanes, where a strong earthquake swarm started offshore just 2 days ago. And this region is known for seismic activity and even submarine eruptions, and as for the most recent history, we don't have to go far back to find some action. And the largest earthquake this time was magnitude 4.5. And this made me wonder how this relates to the bigger picture, because earthquake swarms there have this tendency to migrate onshore, and it is a good idea to remind you of a video I made recently about a row of craters near Grindavík called Eldvörp. And an article that I found on the Volcano Cafe website while making that video. This article claims that there is a magma dike offshore that originates just about where the earthquakes are now, and that dike fed the eruptions that created those impressive Eldvörp craters near Grindavík. And that was during the 13th century. And between those craters and Grindavík, magma intrusion number 3 by the mountain Thorbjörn, that is situated between the village Grindavík and the Blue Lagoon. So what does those earthquakes mean, judging from what experts have been saying? Number 1, this fades out. Statistics say that it is the most likely scenario, and this will only be remembered as a part of a longer chain of events. And number 2, this will eventually lead to an offshore eruption, but that might take a while. And the earthquakes are deep down now. The larger earthquakes are at 10 km depth on average, and experts have not told us anything about whether those earthquakes are tectonic or if this is magma on the move, or a little bit of both. So it's no reason for tourists to get worried, since this is probably just a part of a larger chain of events. But scenario number 3, I'm very curious about that one, since it might fit this theory in this article I mentioned, or this magma dike that originates offshore, just about where this earthquake swarm peaked, and the ground was also shaking by Grindavík, and still is today. So I have been asking myself, from my limited knowledge, might we find ourselves once again monitoring this mountain by Grindavík? Is magma intrusion number 4 on the way, and were those other land uplift events there related to magma and the dike that is supposed to be there? It is a bit far-fetched idea in a way, and I'm only guessing, since I have seen this before. After strong offshore earthquakes on the Reykjanes Ridge, things can get shaky on the peninsula. And all I know for sure is that this leaves me with plenty of room to speculate, and that is what makes geology exciting for me. And those earthquakes are taking place not far away from this coast, where the Mid-Atlantic Ridge, or the Reykjanes Ridge, as we call it in our own territory, is rising up from the seabed. And it is enough to go back to the 13th century to see traces of underwater volcanic eruptions around. Like this rock there is a crater rim from an eruption that actually migrated onshore, or just around here. And as we move closer, we can see a cross-section of one of the craters. Or where the Mid-Atlantic Ridge becomes an ocean ridge on dry land that we call Iceland. And I have come to the opinion that we could just as well have 2 eruptions on Reykjanes in 2023. The seismic unrest dropped a lot and stayed like that after the first 2 eruptions, but now it is nothing like that. But let's leave that for later and move on to Askja Volcano. And recently I made a video where I mentioned an interview with a volcanologist that wants the Askja region evacuated, and that stirred things up big time. But in a good way, geologists are coming forward with different opinions now, and this is also a big deal for a national park and the tourism industry around the volcano, and this discussion was in fact very much needed. And for a while I was very sure that they were about to close a big part of the national park around the volcano. But I did however manage to go up there with a friend of mine, so I could at least get some of the last images from this landscape that might change a lot during the next major eruption that might be on the way, but what is the status there now? And that's simple. This explosion crater from the 1875 eruption and is in fact a popular bathing spot. It has warmed by 9 degrees. The crater is actually called Viti, which means hell in English. And Icelandic scientists have left a clear message for tourists there. Do not bathe in hell until we know more about the status there. And yesterday, a steam column was reported over this lava field from 1921, and pilots doing sightseeing flights with tourists reported the smell of sulfur above the lake. And the status now is that it's business as usual, although this fine volcanologist that I have great respect for stirred things up. But there are scientists there now with gas detectors and some gadgets. I actually offered them to try my thermal drone there. It's a long shot, but at least I can say I tried, and I did send them video samples, so at least they know what this thing can do. And as things stand now, August 16th, it looks as the area won't be closed, but something will definitely be done to increase the safety of tourists. All scientists agree that Askja is preparing for an eruption, but it might take some time, even years. The land subsided by 1.5 meters the years before the 70 centimeter land uplift started, so it seems to be plenty of room for more magma, and the seismic activity or lack of seismic activity supports that. And this debate is only about one thing: will we get warnings in time to evacuate? Should we give public safety the benefit of the doubt, like the volcanologist is asking for? But other experts seem to say the same. Before Askja wakes up, we will get more warnings to evacuate the area safely. However, some of the warnings could be large earthquakes, and with the unstable crater rims around the lake, that's yet another problem, and we just don't know what's cooking down there. And to give public safety the benefit of the doubt is the common sense. But if we take it too far, we are talking about to close a large portion of the highlands for even years, and the volcano could just as well go to sleep again. So I think that the solution will be somewhere in the middle. This area will close in just a few weeks anyway. There is no winter road there, and this debate has been extremely good for safety. It has sharpened the lines when it comes to the decision to close the area, but there was a remarkably little discussion about it this summer, and we need to change our approach when it comes to information to tourists. So I will follow up on this one for sure, and Reykjanes as well. Something is cooking under there. I was hoping to get a short break after the eruption came to an end, since I'm running out of time to capture summer footage, but I can't skip stories like this, since I know very well that in 100 years or so, even less, this channel will be nothing but a very long documentary. And a chapter like this, I can't skip them. And I do have more big news coming up. So I will be uploading a new video very soon about Iceland's largest caldera and the land uplift that was just discovered around there. Or yet another volcano getting ready. And this time, it's the big one. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.